Welcome! This is Dr. Plague, and today we're, what's that?
Can you make a name plaque for our hamster on a CNC machine?
Okay, what do you want on this plaque?
It's a name plaque, so put her name on it. Pepper.
Yes, of course. I mean, what was I thinking? Maybe a date or something?
After you make the plaque.
Fair enough. Then today we're going to have part one of a three-part series on making a plaque using a CNC machine. In these three videos, we're going to show you the entire process from start to finish. We'll be using the Sainsmart Genmitsu 3018 Pro for the CNC machine. This you are not going to want to miss, so stick around. Small CNC machines are becoming more popular among makers, and they are reasonably priced, so anyone can get started in CNC machining. They can be a little intimidating, though, especially if you have never used one. You might be wondering how to get started. In this three-part series, I will take you through the entire process of designing and CNC machining a simple name plaque. In the first video, we are going to design the plaque on the computer using CAD software, and then create the output files needed to operate the CNC machine. In the second video that will follow this one, we will take the output files to the CNC machine and let it rip. The third video will show you the final steps in finishing the plaque. We'll be working fast in this video today, so if you'd like to follow along, you might want to rewatch this video several times to get the most out of it. There are a couple pieces of software needed to design and CNC machine this plaque. The first piece of software we need is some type of CAD package to design our plaque with. I will be using FreeCAD, and some of you might remember it from a previous video of mine on 3D printing a custom part. Be sure to watch this video if you haven't already done so. FreeCAD doesn't require a license and it's free to use. The second piece of software that is needed will be a G-code sender. This is used to send the output files from the computer to the CNC machine. You can also use an offline controller, but there are some problems with the one that was offered for the CNC machine that we are using, so we will not use it. The G-code sender that I am using is called Candle. It is free to use and can be downloaded for free. So let's get started and load up FreeCAD. Mrs. Plague showed me the basic shape that she wants for this plaque, so I will try to create this for her. I'm going to create a new project and save it as Pepper. I will select the part design workbench from the pull-down. Then I'll create a body and create a sketch using the XY plane to draw the plaque in two dimensions. I'm going to create an arc on the horizontal axis and set it to 90 degrees. I'll give it a radius of 1 inch. I will move it 4 inches from the vertical axis. I'm going to create a B spline, attach it to the arc and the vertical axis, and give it 2 points of adjustment. I will move it 2 inches from the horizontal axis, set the first adjustment point to the coordinates of negative 3 and 2. And set the second adjustment point to the coordinates of negative 1/3 and 5/8. I will create a symmetric copy of it about the vertical axis then about the horizontal axis. Perfect. Now I'm going to pad this out to half an inch. See how it is now a three-dimensional object? I'm going to reverse the pad so that the top lies on the XY plane. This will make it easier to apply the text. I will select the draft workbench from the pull-down, then create a shape string. This will allow us to create text, and I will choose a font. I will create the string Pepper with a height of 1 3/4 inches and set the appropriate X and Y positions for the text. Now, let's go back to the part design workbench and move everything 4 inches to the right and 2 inches upwards to put the origin at the lower left. This will provide the starting origin for the CNC machine. I will now select the path workbench from the pull-down. This will allow us to define the paths that the CNC machine takes to move the router bit around when routing. We will end up creating two separate output files, one for the outline of the plaque and the other for the text. Now, I will create a path job for the outline of the plaque. I will set the stock to 1/4 inch thicker than the plaque, since we will be using 3/4 inch wood. This will be for visualization. Now, I'll add an 1/8 inch bit for our router bit and remove the default tool. Let's name our output file pepperplaque.nc and set it as a GRBL file. Next, we create a contour path for the router to go around the plaque edge. I'll set the depth to 0 inches and route down 1/2 inch deep in increments of 1/50 inch. Then, I'll set the feed rate to 5 inches per minute. Setting a spindle speed of 1000 will indicate 100% speed for this particular CNC machine. And here's the path the router bit will take in green. We will simulate this in a bit, but first, let's create another path job for the text. I'll create a stock of 1/4 inch thick for the text, just for visualization. This time, I'll select a smaller 1.6mm router bit to route the text and remove the default tool. Let's name this output file peppername.nc and set it as a GRBL file. Then, we'll create a path pocket to route out the text. I'll choose zigzag offset with a 50% stepover percentage and a pass extension of -0.15 inch to route it out cleanly. I'll select each letter for the base geometry, which will route out each letter. We will route the letters 0.60 inch deep in 0.10 inch deep passes. We'll also use 5 inches per minute for the feed rate with a spindle speed of 1000, the same as 100%. Now, here is the route path for the letters added in green. Now, let's simulate this before taking it to the CNC machine. First, I'll simulate the outside edge. And now, routing of the text is simulated. Finally, I'll use the post-processor to create the output files, which will be G-code files that the CNC machine will understand. I'll make one for the outside edge and one for the text. And here are the NC output files ready for the CNC machine to use. So, now we are all ready to bring our files to the CNC machine, and we'll save that for next time. That's all the fun we have time for today. Please leave any comments or questions below, and I'll try to answer as many as I can. So, if you like this video, be sure to peck at that like button, and don't forget to subscribe, and peck at that notification bell to be notified of all my new videos as they become available. Thank you, and we'll see you next time right here on Dr. Plaque.